Everybody, Don Summers here with guns.com. Today we're going to do another video in the series, My First Gun. Now the last one featured my son. We had a lot of great comments. Today, this one's going to feature my daughter, but there's a twist to it. And just so you know, all my kids have been properly trained in the safety and the usage of firearms. Every time they graduated college, they got to enter my gun room and pick the gun of their choice. I'll let my daughter take it from here.
Hi, I'm Mia, Don's daughter. As he said, he gifted us a gun for graduation. I knew I wanted a handgun, so I chose his Glock 26. It's small, fits my hand perfectly, and I like the sights on it. When we were growing up, he helped us feel real comfortable around guns, taught us all safety precautions, taught us how to target shoot. So I'm generally pretty comfortable around guns and how to use them. I just never really anticipated being in a situation where it might be crucial to have one. About 4 years ago, shortly after my husband and I were married, we were living in Baltimore City. He was at work. I was home from work because I was preparing for a job interview in the city that morning. It was about 10 a.m. I was upstairs and I heard this glass shatter, and I thought it was a large picture we had hanging in the living room that had just fallen off the wall. So I started to walk down the stairs to go see what happened. And shortly after that, I heard a couple voices and I heard the alarm start going off and realized that the glass that shattered was actually our back door. Someone had thrown a brick through it and then reached in and unlocked the door to get into the house. So I ran back upstairs, immediately called my husband at work, told him what was going on because I knew the alarm system would call the police. We actually do have a large dog, which I had thought previously might help us in a situation like this. He was actually really spooked by the alarm, so he was just shaking and didn't want to go downstairs to investigate either. So I stayed on the phone with my husband, and when he left work, he passed the phone to his brother so that I could continue talking to someone and stay on the phone with someone while they were there. I went in and grabbed the gun from our bedroom as well. I chambered around and decided to yell down to the intruders that I had the gun and it was ready to go and that they needed to get out of the house. Once I yelled that, I heard them scramble and knock furniture over to grab whatever they could and just get out. So I don't think, one, they anticipated anyone being home, and two, anticipated whoever might be home would load a gun. So at that point, I just took my dog and I went into our bedroom and locked the door, and I waited until the police got there and my husband got there. I'm thankful that I had the gun in that moment. I really appreciated after that, especially what my dad taught us growing up with safety and how to handle a gun and the target shooting. I never thought that someone would break into my house, especially during the day while I was home. So I was really happy to have a way to defend myself.
Well, we hope you appreciated today's video. If you did, please like and share it. And don't forget to subscribe for more great content. And if you're in the market for a great defensive weapon, you know where to go, guns.com. Y'all take care.